an army marches on its stomach, or so the old saying goes. Food is one of the most important resources in Age of Empires 2. We use it to feed our villagers, to research technologies, and to sling our allies to imp while they're making double castle arambai. When we think about food gathering bonuses, we might think about the early power spikes of the Mongolian hunters or the Indian shore fishers, both of which provide incredible Dark Age bonuses on certain maps. Or we might think about the vast economic boosts of the farming bonuses of the Khmer and Slavs. Or we could look to the seas, where we find an Imperial Age Japanese fishing ship with the gill nets technology, which, if we discount the sailing time to travel back and forth between a dock and a deep sea fish, can gather at an impressive 0.735 food per second. In an ordinary game, these fishing ships are the fastest collectors of food that Aoe2 has to offer. But we're not content with the ordinary, oh no. We must look to the extraordinary. The rate at which a unit gathers resources is controlled by the work rate attribute, which determines the amount of resource gathered per in-game second. Villagers are not represented as a single unit, but rather consist of multiple units that are swapped out depending upon the task they're performing. Shepherds, foragers, hunters, fishers, and farmers all have different work rates, controlling the base rate at which they collect food before any bonuses are applied. Farmers do have the highest rate at 0.53 food per second, but their effective gather rate is slower since they spend time walking around and are limited by the amount of food present on the farms. But all of these work rates pale in comparison to that of the standard villager unit, who boasts a work rate of 1. Villagers turn from non-villager villagers into villager villagers when they enter combat, including combat with wolves. If wolves or other predator animals were to have food on them, then villager villagers would be able to collect it. And that idea brings us to one of the features that the user patch added to random map scripting, an object's resource delta. This attribute lets map scripters change the resources present on any given object. With it, we can reduce the amount of gold on gold mines, increase the amount of wood on trees, and, in general, change any resource value that we want. The AI scripters often let their AIs fight it out on the Fen Crazy map, a map that provides a unique challenge by randomly changing the values of many resources. And in addition to these standard resource objects, we can set a resource delta for wolves and other predator animals. By doing this, we give them food for villager villagers to gather, and they gather at their ridiculously high rate of 1 food per second.
Yes, that is the pelt of the great wolf.
Let's do a comparison by putting 100 food on berries, sheep, deer, boar, shorefish, and wolves, and removing the decay from dead animals. We can use DE's new progress bars to get a comparison of their gather rates, and the wolf villager outgathers everyone else by a wide margin. Now, this mechanic isn't present in standard maps, but occasionally there are tournaments or show matches with custom maps that use this feature. One of the T90 series matches featured Jaguar Den, a custom map by the Mad Catter. This map gives 100 food to all jaguars. Here, we see TaToH taking advantage and collecting his jaguar food at ludicrous speed. Later on, MBL tries to treat TaToH as though he were Melmano by going for a jaguar rush, but that just ends up bringing more food into TaToH's economy. One final note, predator animals still obey the rules of food spoilage followed by other animals. If we kill a wolf with a TC or military unit instead of a villager, the corpse will have a disappointing 0 food left over instead of a delicious 100. So keep an eye out for this feature, as occasionally it will show up in custom maps, and you'll want to take advantage of any extra food you can get. Thank you all very much for watching. Extra thanks to everyone supporting me on Patreon, and I'll see you next time. Oh, and for everyone who enjoys a bad pun, farms, berries, and fish are all stationary, sheep and wolves have a movement rate of 0.7 tiles per second, deer have a speed of 0.737, and boar have a speed of 0.8. But there's also a charging bonus for attacking animals, with their graphics having a multiplier to increase their speeds to 0.96 for boar, 1.05 for wolves, and 1.4003 for deer. So deer take first place in the race for fastest food.